Hello there. Well, now I have a story called A Southern Time Christmas by Robert Bernardini and illustrated by James Rice. It'll be a Southern Time Christmas, and it'll be read by someone from the North Pole. Here in the South, where the sweet blossoms grow, the holiday season comes rarely with snow. The weather is mild, the sunshine is fine, and we love our Christmas a good Southern time. So gather the young'uns and grown-up ones too. Sit back and relax, and you can kick off your shoes. And I'll tell you a tale full of down-home good cheer of how Christmas works when it travels down here. On a warm Christmas Eve just a few years ago, I was out on my porch swing, just taking things slow, when all of a sudden a light struck my eye, a red light so bright that it lit up the sky. It flew to the left and it flew to the right, and when it came closer it grew very bright. In a flash and a scream it flew right overhead. 1 second it stayed and then away off it sped. Well, I jumped off my seat when I heard something thump out in the garden right next to the stump. I said to myself, now what could that be? What could that thumped near the old tree? My courage I mustered with hardly a sound. I crept through my garden and looked all around. And what did I find to my big surprise? A cute little elf. He was tall as my thigh. He had straw-colored hair and bright rosy cheeks, tall pointed ears and cute little feet, and his green overalls and his little red cap made him look like a Christmas toy freshly unwrapped. Now, just to be sure that this wasn't a dream, I pinched myself hard, so hard I could scream. Then I said to the elf, hey, what do you say? Where are you from? Did you lose your way? He looked up at me and said in despair, I fell off the sleigh as I flew through the air, flying so fast all the night long, sometimes it's hard just to hang on. My eyes opened wide. Now, could it be true? Could it be true that you're one of his crew? Yes, it is so, the little elf said. I'm a helper of Santa, and my name is Jed. How lucky, I cried, I do declare, to meet Jed the elf who fell from the air. So tell me, my friend, now what is it like to fly with Saint Nick on Christmas Eve night? That's a secret, he said, as he looked at the ground and shuffled his feet on my cabbage patch mound. And it's never been told to a woman or man, so I better not say for as long as I can. Of course, I said, Jed, I can see what you mean, and I realize that things sometimes ain't what they seem. But I do have a question that won't ask too much, so please let me ask if you're not in a rush. Then we sat on the stump, me and Jed side by side, and I saw he was sad by the look in his eye. But I spoke not a word as I watched his expression, till he said with a sigh, okay, ask me your question. I replied with a smile, I thought y'all wore big heavy coats and mittens and more, but you're dressed like me, a true Southern man. Now, Jed, tell me true, is that part of the plan? Well, it must have been right. I must have been right, this question I asked, 'cause he picked up his head and his eyes lit up fast, and I saw he was moved by some deep-seated pride, and the answer would flow like a swift-running tide. Sir, you are right, he jumped. You have it. The nail on the head with your fine Southern wit. Me and old Santa stay bundled up tight. when we're flying up north on Christmas Eve night. But once we fly over the Mason-Dixon, once we cross over that line, we get fixin' to taking off coats and sweaters and such, and wearing these overalls we love so much. We take off our scarves and our stocking caps, we take off our mittens, and then we start to clap, 'cause Santa and I are so glad to be here, so we can spread joy and good southern cheer. We fly due south as fast as we may, as Rudolph's red nose lights up all the way. We fly fast as light, we have to see you. The whole south is waiting for Santa and me. Even sometimes Santa makes mistakes reading it, and that's okay. We visit the cities, the towns, and the farms, and each different place has its own special charm. We fly over backwoods and fields of cotton, beaches and bayous, not one place forgotten. And in every house and in every dwelling, Santa leaves presents without ever telling. But if there's a chimney too small for St. Nick, I will squeeze through, 'cause I'm small and I'm quick. But flying all night makes us hungry as blazes, so we snack on the victuals that Mrs. Claus made us, of chicken and dumplings, home fries and grits. Down home southern food always gives us a lift. But tonight, as I finished my glass of iced tea, Santa turned sharply without warning me. I slid off my seat and I fell from the sleigh, and before I could yell, he was far, far away. And that's what he told me, this little elf Jed, and I listened real closely and nodded my head. Then I saw a small tear fall from his elf eye, and I thought for a moment that I too might cry. Then I said, oh me Jed, I'm really sorry for you fell. How can I help? Can I give Nick a yell? If you think it might help, he sighed, but I fear that Santa is probably too far from here. Well, I puffed up my chest with all of my might. I yelled, Santa, come back here. Come back here tonight. And just as I had finished this loud southern roar, I saw that red light streaking towards me once more. They flew fast as the light. In a blink they were here. Santa, his sleigh, and those magic reindeer. In midair they hovered a few feet away, and Rudolph's red nose made it look bright as day. Santa looked jolly, alive, and alert, and his red overalls, red cap, and white shirt. The sleigh was deep red, and the reindeer were gray, and from that big sleigh, old St. Nicholas waved. Santa yelled, Ho there! We've found our elf Jed. Climb up here, my boy, and we'll speed on ahead. But before we fly off, I must thank our friend for signaling me with his loud southern roar. For I had no idea which way I should go, but this fine southern gent with his yell let me know. You should be proud of your true southern ways, and I hope we will meet you again one of these days. Then he gave me a nod and a wink of his eye, and he pulled on the reins for the reindeer to fly, and I heard him call out as they flew out of sight, Merry Christmas, y'all, and y'all a good night. And that's the end.